Hello dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Ruchi Bhargav, Assistant Professor in Education, Khalsa College of Education, Ranjit Avenue, Amritsar. Well students, today we will discuss about the topic Comparative Study of Multi-Level System of Educational Administration among some developed and some developing countries. The objectives of the present module are to study the meaning and functions of educational administration, to explain educational administration of some developed and developing countries, to compare the educational administration of developed and developing countries. Let us start with the meaning of educational administration. Educational administration is regarded as total processes inclusive of all responsibilities and functions necessary for running the school. It provides and manages various elements of the teaching learning situation, such as learners, the teachers, the curriculum, and the socio-physical environment. There are different functions of administration in a school management program. These are planning, organizing, directing and controlling. In the absence of these functions, the school cannot function effectively. Now, we will focus on major functions of educational administration. Some of the major functions of educational administration are as follows: planning, organization, direction and controlling. Planning. Planning is an essential component. It is a useful exercise to be undertaken by the administrators. It involves systematic, organized, and an articulated scheme of working. Organization. Organization is also an important function of good administration. The effective and efficient work of the school depends upon the good organization. The essential elements of the organization are the people, what they do and how they work together. Direction. Direction is an important function of educational administration. Direction involves getting the work done through instructions and orders. There should be proper supervision, motivation, and communication on the part of the administrator for getting the work done. Last but not the least, controlling. Controlling involves measuring and monitoring performance, comparing results with plans, and taking corrective action when required. It indicates how far the goals have been achieved and to what extent there is deviation from the plans. So, the administration is concerned with managing resources, allocating tasks, making decisions, and solving problems. For effective organization, good administration should involve planning, organizing, directing, motivating, controlling, and decision making. Now, we will study about evolution of concept of management in education. Educational management as a field of study and practice was derived from management principles first applied to industry and commerce, mainly in the United States. Theory development largely involved the application of industrial models to educational settings. By the 21st century, the main theories had either been developed in the educational context or had been adapted from industrial models to meet the specific requirements of schools and colleges. Educational management has progressed from being a new field dependent upon ideas developed in other settings to become an established field with its own theories and research. Now, we will learn the concept of multi-level educational administration in different countries. Education can transform a person to lead a better life and also helps in maintaining social well-being of the society. Education helps a person to show their best with mind and spirit. It gives a lot of knowledge in various aspects. education is also important for a country to grow. That's why every country should pay more attention for its educational administration. As we know that the principle of decentralization is also concerned with effective administration. Decentralization is defined as the transfer of decision-making authority closer to the consumer or beneficiary. This can take the form of transferring powers to lower levels of an organization, which is called deconcentration or administrative decentralization. A popular form of deconcentration in education is to give additional responsibilities to the schools. Another form of decentralization called devolution entails transferring powers to lower levels of government. Most often, educational responsibilities are transferred to general purpose governments at the regional or local levels. As you can see in the picture that in multi-level educational administration, there are three levels: top, middle and lower. Example of the decentralization of basic education to local district level governments is India and Pakistan. In rare cases, additional responsibilities are given to single purpose governments such as the local school district in the United States. In France, education is highly centralized at the level of the national government, whereas in Canada, the national government does not even have an education ministry. And in the United States, education is mainly the responsibility of local school districts. Many developing countries and countries in transition to market economies have highly centralized government, administration to education and other public services. Now, we will focus on the comparison of educational administration in some developed countries. Educational administration in United States of America. The United States Department of Education is a cabinet-level department of the United States government. The Department of Education is administered by the United States Secretary of Education. The primary function of the Department of Education are to establish policy, administer and coordinate most federal assistance to education, and to collect data of US schools. The Department of Education does not establish schools or colleges. The department's mission is to promote student achievement and preparation for global competitiveness by fostering educational excellence and ensuring equal access. Now, we will learn about regulating bodies and their role concerned with educational administration and coordination in USA. The first one is United States Department of Education. The executive branch agency responsible for federal education programs of all types and levels and headed by Secretary of Education is a presidential cabinet appointment. The Department of Education does not function as a governing body but operates in cooperation with state and local authorities. The second regulating body is Association of Governing Boards of Universities and Colleges. The AGB is a membership organization of the governing boards of higher education institutions, both public and private. It does not exercise control over these boards, but rather represents their interests and provides information and training materials. The third body is Association of Community College Trustees. The ACCT functions as a representational organization for members of governing boards of public community colleges and state and local community college systems. the fourth governing body is National Association of State Boards of Education. The main role of this body is to coordinate state boards of education. The fifth governing body is National Association of State Directors of Vocational and Technical Education. This body coordinates and represents the state and territorial officials and offices that oversee vocational education programs. The other bodies which are deeply concerned with educational administration in USA are American Council on Education, American Association of Collegiate Registrars and Admissions Officers, etc. Now, we will discuss the educational administration in Japan. After the Meiji Restoration in 1868, education in Japan was implemented and taken forward within a centralized system as a matter of national policy aimed at laying the foundation for the establishment of Japan as a modern state. However, after the end of World War II, as one element of democratic reform, a process of educational reform was carried out aimed at the democratization and decentralization of education. Now, we will study the structure of educational administration of local governments in Japan. The first body is Boards of Education. The bodies that bear responsibility for educational administration in Japan at local government level are prefectures and municipalities, cities, wards, towns and villages, as well as boards of education which perform a leading role and are established as representative councils within each local public body to deal with educational matters. The next structure is Superintendent of the Board of Education. A Superintendent of Education is placed in charge of all the duties pertaining to the authority of a Board of Education to be carried out under the direction and supervision of the board members. The following duties are stipulated in Article 23 of the Local Education Administration Law as falling within the professional authority of the Board of Education. The main duties include matters pertaining to school education, matters pertaining to education of young people and of women, and to the running of citizens' hall and other aspects of social education, matters pertaining to the structural organization of school, the curriculum, learning guidance, pupil guidance and professional duties, etc. The principles of the division of responsibilities between the state and local public bodies are defined in the local autonomy law. It is stipulated as a basic principle of the division of responsibilities between the state and local public bodies that the task of a local public body shall be to promote the welfare of its residents, for which purpose it shall carry out a wide range of tasks in the autonomous and comprehensive performance of local public administration. Now, we will discuss the role of the central government. The role of central government in compulsory education is firstly to establish the fundamental framework of the system of school education. Central government establishes criteria for compulsory education over the whole of Japan. In addition to the above, central government also establishes criteria for the organization of classes into grades and for the permitted number of teachers in respect of elementary and junior high schools. Now, we will study the role of local public bodies in educational administration in Japan. In the field of educational administration, a major supporting pillar which stands alongside school education is social education. In the fundamental law of education, it is stipulated that with a need to responding to the desires of the individual or the needs of society, education carried out within the setting of society shall be encouraged by the state and by local public bodies. Fundamental Law of Education, Article 12. Let us discuss some features of educational administration observed in developed countries. The features characterizing educational administration and management in developed countries are obviously a result of national traditions and history on one hand, and of the values and pattern of different models of organization which presently dominate the public sector on the other. The division of the tasks and responsibilities between the state, local authorities, educational institutions and non-governmental agents, therefore, offers a rather confusing picture in most Western societies today. The main features of educational administration observed in developed countries are: the first feature is from centralized to decentralized administration to a hybrid administrative system. Both centralized systems, such as the French, and decentralization systems, such as the British, have in recent years tried to move towards what might be called hybrid administrative systems. In these systems, the management of activities is decentralized and responsibility is given to individual schools and universities, while the state has the role of the setting of educational objectives, norms and rules addressing national policy issues and the monitoring of overall education system. Second one is from a rigid concept of model of school management to bureaucratic centralism. In some countries, schools are encouraged to compete for excellence and achievement in the area of school management. In France, for example, the education projects approach for secondary schools relies heavily on the producers and consumers of education in the definition of their targets and aims for each school. Third feature is predominantly rigid and unified delivery systems of education and training. Controlled by the state or very few specialized institutions, agencies, to increasingly diverse delivery system to which a wide variety of growing number of agencies and actors that are not necessarily specialized in education services only contribute on more or less ad hoc basis. One may notably refer in this respect to the increasingly important role of public and private mass media in the production and dissemination of education programs and materials. For example, United Kingdom. Last but not the least is quality control and regulation. Some countries have declared the importance they attach to educational purpose of evaluation, shifting emphasis in their concern from input to outcome, while others stress the need for higher accountability, where there is concern because the use of resource remains very much in demand. However, there seems to be an agreement for the need to strengthen the capacity of the state to regulate the system and ensure quality control by using evaluation to that end, and at the same time for reducing its authority for direct management. Next, we will learn the comparative study of educational administration in some developing countries. Firstly, we will discuss about educational administration in India. The main body to regulate educational administration in India is Ministry of Education. The Indian government is quasi-federal in nature. The union government and the state government together are responsible for the development of education in the country. Hence, separate ministries are formed for smooth functioning of the departments. The main ministry is Central Ministry. On 26th September 1985, the Government of India created a new ministry in the name of Ministry of Human Resource Development. This ministry is responsible for educational development of the country. The ministry has two departments, that is, Department of School Education and Literacy and Department of Higher Education. Under the former, there are two subcategories. First one is elementary education. At the pre-primary stage, 0 to 6 years, there is the attempt to establish a linkage between early childhood care and education and other development programs. The principle of decentralization has been extended to the management of primary education, and village education committees have been set up in many parts of the country. These committees are responsible for the enrollment and retention of children in schools, supervise the functioning of schools, check teacher absenteeism, and mobilize additional resources for the school. Next division is secondary education and adult education. At the state level, it is usually the Department of Education that administers secondary education. At the national level, the Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, New Delhi, runs the Kendriya Vidyalayas, central schools, while the Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, New Delhi, runs the Navodaya Vidyalayas, that is, school for talented rural children. The Central Board of Secondary Education, CBSC, New Delhi, functions under the overall supervision of the Department of Education, Ministry of Human Resource Development, and Government of India. There are boards of secondary education in each state as well. Under the latter, there are 6 subcategories, namely University and Higher Education, Technical Education, Book Promotion and Copyright, Scholarships, Languages, and Minority Education. Now, we will focus on state ministry which are involved in educational administration. The states of India have their separate ministries for education. The ministry has education of a particular state consists of a cabinet minister followed by a state minister. The state governments also formulate policies for education. In India, some statutory councils and apex bodies are also related with administration of education. These councils or apex bodies are either established by the state governments or by the central government. They are responsible for recognition of courses, promotion of professional institutions, and providing grants to undergraduate and postgraduate programs and various awards. The important national council of the country include All India Council for Technical Education, Indian Council for Agricultural Research, National Council for Teacher Education, and National Council of Educational Research and Training, etc. At the state level, functions similar to the NCERT are performed by the SCERTs. The apex institution concerned with educational planning and administration is the National University of Educational Planning and Administration. This institution conducts research, organizes training, provides consultancy services and disseminates important information on innovations, changes and developments in the area of planning and management. Many states are also in the process of setting up state institutes of educational management and training to assist state level educational planning and training of educational planners and administrators. Now, we will study the educational administration in Pakistan. The division of responsibilities between the provinces and the center are defined by the Constitution of Pakistan in 1973. The Federal Ministry of Education has the overall responsibility for the development and coordination of national policies, plans and programs in education including curriculum development, while implementation of the policies is the responsibility of the local administration. Each province has its own Department of Education. Educational institutions located in the Federal Capital Territory are administered directly by the Ministry of Education. Now, we will study the educational administration of school education in Pakistan. Primary and secondary education is provided by public and private schools as well as by Islamic madrasa. School education is organized by the Ministry of Education. The curriculum wing within the ministry formulates the national framework curriculum through a wide stakeholder consultation. The inter-board committee of chairman controls the 26 boards of intermediate and secondary education. The boards, one federal and other provincial affiliate schools, implement, regulate and monitor schemes of studies and curricula and hold secondary school certificate and higher secondary school certificate exams. Educational administration of private education. Before 1972, private educational institutions constituted a substantial proportion of the total educational system of schools and colleges. In 1972, the Pakistan government nationalized all private educational institutions. Permission to set up educational institutions is granted either by the Ministry of Education or the respective provincial education department. Registered private schools have to follow a government prescribed curriculum. Lastly, we will discuss some features of educational administration observed in developing countries. First feature is decentralization. Most developing countries have decentralized some key functions and responsibilities to lower levels of administration. Many patterns or arrangements are observed in these countries. School-based management aimed at giving schools and communities more autonomy in decision making. Second feature is growth of educational models. Most developing countries are emphasizing the virtues of choice and competition, either within the state sector or through an expanded role for the private sector. In many developing countries, low-fee private schools are emerging as another source of choice and competition, often outside government regulation. Third feature is public and private sector roles in provision and financing of education. As far as education sector management is concerned, most developing countries have involved the private sector in the financing and provision of education. Private sector involvement in education can be found in a variety of forms, including full-fee private schools, publicly supported and privately managed schools, community schools and private funding, fees and donation to public schools and private tutoring. Fourth feature is quality assurance system. There are generally three primary models of quality assurance: assessment, audit and accreditation. These are all seen operating in the developing countries. The bodies overseeing these tasks differ greatly, however, depending on the country context. Some countries, for example, Australia, India, New Zealand, have different agencies for different levels of education, while others have a central agency overseeing all of these tasks, like Thailand and Vietnam, etc. To summarize, this module compares multi-level system of educational administration among some developed and developing countries. One of the greatest asset any country has in developing its social health and its economic health is its school system. High quality education leads to an educated workforce, thereby increasing economic capital in the improvement of country. An enlightened citizen is important to the welfare of a nation. In USA, Canada, Australia, Japan, and other developed countries, educational administrative systems are based mainly on the American models. In these countries, administration institutes include public and private schools, technical education colleges, special education institutions, and public and private universities. The main features in developing countries are decentralization, involving grassroots level structure and multi-level administration. Thank you.